Good morning. I am Christelle from Frans de Klerk Independent Technical Analysts. We had quite a few questions around Naspers and Prosus, and we can't look at them unless we have a look at what happened on the technical graph on Tencent. At the moment, we see, and we've warned before, about this left shoulder, head, and right shoulder on Tencent. And we can see that once that 40-week moving average on Tencent started to change into a resistance week after week after week, that was when the red lights were flashing that the long-term sentiment has changed to negative, and that it was probably time to take some money off the table, because not only was the head and shoulder warning, that 40-week moving average, that red line, just could not change into a support. And at that stage, it was waiting at around 609 Hong Kong dollars. Very important, this week I've used a Williams percentage R indicator to highlight oversold or overbought levels. Now, this indicator's interval moves around a 0 to a minus 80, minus 90. We talk about it being oversold when it is below a minus 80, which means the probability of the instrument to bounce to higher levels is more likely. And once it is around 0, we talk about it being overbought, meaning the possibility and the probability of the instrument to retrace, to pull back, to take some profits off the table is more likely. Now, nothing is a definite science, but we work with possibilities and probabilities. Now, what is very nice about the Williams percentage R indicator is it's got a midline, which is obviously at the minus 50 level. And when it comes from oversold levels and it starts to change that minus 50 line into a support, we assume that the momentum to the top can escalate. When it comes from overbought levels and it starts to change that minus 50 level into a resistance, we assume that the momentum to the top, or to the bottom, excuse me, can escalate. Let's just quickly test that. Back here, March 2020, yes, my minus 50 level was tested, bounced, and the momentum to the top escalated. Coming down here back, 14 September 2020, tested it, not really kept it a resistance, the minus 50, changed it back into a support. Once it did that, again, the momentum to the top escalated. Very important, this is a weekly graph. In other words, this candle, the last candle that we are looking at the moment, has not finished yet. So this is a Thursday morning. So by Friday close, if this candle still has a long tail at the bottom, it implies a possible dragonfly candle. A dragonfly candle appears at the bottom after a sell-off with a long tail at the bottom, telling us that the buyers protected the share with a vengeance. Why? The low of this candle is weighted at $422, and they've managed to push the share all the way up to 488 Hong Kong dollars. So this is very, very bullish should this candle remains the same by a Friday close. We've got a window there, and we know the rules around windows are they always get close. Very important, this full target of the length of the head on Tencent, has not played out completely yet. What does that mean? It means if Tencent bounces and does not go back to that resistance of the right shoulder, which is waiting at $640, if it does not get enough buyers to get it through that resistance, because that's where the right shoulder is waiting at the moment, and it starts to retrace again, the full target, and let me just quickly show you what that is, the full target of this head and shoulder formation. Let's get so many touching points there. I want to make sure that that shoulder is solid. That full target of the head on Tencent is obviously the length projected downwards from the neckline, can take Tencent back to $343, all right? That is another, from the low where it was, that is another 20%, all right? If it gets above the 40-week, beautiful. Long-term sentiment changes to positive again. That is waiting at 614 Hong Kong dollars. If it gets above the neckline, all the red-faced will, you know, become a little bit more pale. They will be able to breathe a little. very, very important, that high on that 640 Hong Kong dollars, that's that strong resistance that needs to be overcome on Tencent to take this head and shoulder formation completely off the table. Because once, if it does not do that, in the back of our heads, we must remember that that full target of that head can still be in place. So having said that, we know that Tencent is basically the fuel for Naspers and Prices. Let's have a look at Naspers. And obviously, because of that bullish candle on Tencent, we know that they definitely protected it yesterday. Have a look, long tail at the bottom. The low on Naspers yesterday was 2,478.68. Tested it, pushed it all the way back to close at 2,747.47. Big question, will this candle remain the same by a Friday close? Have a look at Mike Williams' percentage R. It bounced from oversold levels. So all the, you know, happiness makes the probability of a bounce bigger. But it's already losing steam. Orange light is flashing. Because it tells me that my indicator might preempt something that will happen in my price action. So very, very important, if we go back, let's draw in, and obviously you can draw in as many support and resistance levels that you want on Naspers to identify, you know, critical levels to protect. At the moment, that line at 2,736.49 has to remain a support. I can even take it a little bit higher and just count the amount of testing points, and that looks like a better line if I look at the amount of points it touches. 2,805.46 has to change into a support and remain one. Again, and I know we repeat it every week, but ladies and gentlemen, if we look at the graphs and we look back in hindsight, that red line, that 40-week moving average, if you know nothing of technical analysis, just obey the rule. Just obey the rule of the 40-week moving average. Once the share starts to change it into a resistance, and it cannot change it back into a support, that's when you have to ask yourself the question, is it worth it to be so greedy? Is it worth it to hold on for longer? Because once that level of the red line, the 40-week moving average, starts to change into a resistance, it can become a lot uglier. So let's hope it bounces. Obviously, we can take all the previous resistance candles, shadows of the candles, or the real bodies, and identify where it possibly can go. 3,020 Rand. For those of you who love Fibonacci levels, if this strong support remains, we can maybe use the high, recent high, back on the week of the 25th of January 2021, and use that as our 100% level, and identify, and look here, at my 38.2% level, I just want to move this so that you can see it. At my 38.2% level, look at that consolidation phase there around that support and resistance level, and that is waiting at 3,019 Rand and 16 cents. It tells us, if Naspers cannot change that level into a support, it means it won't possibly go to the 50% level, which is waiting at 3,186 Rand 18. So use these levels to identify possible strong support and resistance levels. And once they cannot change those resistance levels into a support, take the easy money, because in the back of your head, remember that full target of 10 cent. Yes, it can easily go back to the high. If there's enough protection and enough buyers, yes, it can change that 40-week moving average. But use those support levels to shift up and bank profit as it goes along. My minus 50 level on Naspers has to change into a support on my Williams percentage R before I can assume that the momentum to the top can escalate again. So let's see what happens. It's a bullish candle, which tells me for CFD or short-term traders, if the support remains there on the low at 2,478.68, we can easily see a bounce here in Naspers based on, you know, that beautiful dragonfly candle that we saw on 10 cents. Let's have a look at Prosus. Oh, yeah, maybe I should just spell it correctly. Right, there you go. All right, same story. Long tail at the bottom tells us bullish, buyers protected from the lows. Again, I don't like the fact that my Williams percentage R is just losing steam. Why is it not pointing upwards? Is this indicator telling me that this price action might not last. This bullish price action with the long tail at the bottom might not last. Again, obviously, Prusis also had a little bit of a distorted left shoulder head and right shoulder. Again, very important. Look at that red line of ours, the 40-week moving average. Once the share could not change it into a support, it was downwards from there. So obviously, strong resistance that has to overcome is that high 1,347.35. And again, you can use Fibonacci levels to identify strong support and resistance. And again, look how interesting is this. Just like in Naspers case, in Prusa's case as well, 38.2% level. Look at that resistance there, waiting at 1,400, what is that level? 1,459.89. When it changes that into a support, you can be happy and say, hey, the possibility is now here that Prusa's can go back to my 50% level. That head and shoulder on Tencent makes everybody hold their breath, and myself included. All right, Rowan wanted us to look at Visa. What is a little bit of a concern for me is we had quite a few questions this week on shares for possible long positions when the instrument is overbought. So just to highlight again, that's not where we want to go long or buy a share. We want to do that when it is oversold. All right, so just keep that at the back of your head. Rowan, Visa, obviously very, very overbought at the moment. It had a nice rally, but look what the share has done. For the last 3 weeks, it has stopped making new recent highs. And that is an orange light. It tells you that the buyers are losing steam, and maybe, just maybe, they want to take money off the table and go somewhere else to find more value, more growth, whatever the case might be. So we've got at the moment a possible shooting star candle, long tail at the top. We're after a rally, but remember, these are Thursday graphs, so the whole Friday still needs to be included in this price action before we can make an assumption that that is a shooting star candle. Below, my first sign of weakness will be below $237.27. I would not go long when this instrument is this overbought. And whether you use a Williams percentage, a MACD, a RSI, a stochastic, doesn't matter. When it is overbought, and remember, on a Williams percentage, it is overbought when it is around a zero, because that's the interval on it. When it is overbought, the probability for the instrument to retrace, to come back, to take profit, is much more likely. You want to buy a share or go long on a share when it is oversold, when it is telling you the probability of the instrument to bounce is more likely. In fact, you should start to consider a short position here, not a long one, because stop making new highs. It's already had a massive rally. It is overbought. There is lower highs on your Williams percentage R. So Rowan, I would caution you, do not consider a long unless you are a momentum trader. Never recommend it. But what do we mean by that? When the high of $252.67 starts to change into a support again, you can assume then, hey, the momentum is still upwards. I am going to chase it. It's always risky to do that when the instrument is overbought. Again, Murray wanted us to look at Mastic for a long. Murray, Mastic listed on our local exchange. Sir, it is overbought. It's in my overbought territory. Yes, the momentum to the top can continue. Absolutely. But let's have a look at how far this share has come already. After its consolidation base here, this share has already put in a 33.48% rally. Do you want to buy it at those levels? No, you don't. You want to buy it when it is oversold. And I'm going to use a horizontal line to identify this strong resistance. And that was in the week of the 22nd of February 2021. And that high is waiting at 12 Rand. And look, when it tested 12 Rand then and it retraced, now it's approaching that level. It's 2 cents away from it. So the big question is, will Mastic be able to change that 12 Rand into a support and keep it one? Because it's one thing to just break through it. It can be a false break or a whipsaw. It's a different story to keep it above it. So again, If you are a momentum chaser and a trader, which we never recommend, then yes, you should buy above 12 Rand. Use a stop loss here of around 10 Rand 28. Make sure you look at your average true range to make sure there's enough breathing space for your share. But at the moment with Mastic and the massive rally it had, Murray, I would be careful to buy it at these levels. It can, if I go back and let's look at the history of the share, it is at record highs. And do I want to buy a share when it's at record highs? No, I want to buy it when it starts to stop making lows, make higher lows, becomes oversold, and we can see that the buyers are protecting the share. So there's a matter of caution that I would take here, Murray, on Mastic. I think you should rather consider other shares that are a lot more oversold. Again, Distell. Marguerite wanted us to look at Distell for a long. Look at it. Marguerite, again, the instrument. Whoopsie. And now I've lost my Williams percentage R completely. And it will soon be back. There you go. Let's just make it a lot thicker for you, Marguerite, so that you can see it there. And let's just change it to a blue and not a purple. So that, great. It is overbought. It's approaching that zero level, which tells me, yes, the momentum can maybe continue. There's no guarantee that it won't, but look at the rally that it had. So if you want to use the previous patterns on Distell and say, Christel, every time it pulled back, it rallied. Pulled back, it rallied. Pulled back, it rallied. Yes, then you can buy the dips and make sure that once those resistances every time change into a support, you can add to the position. It just becomes difficult. After so many pullbacks, the question is, how high can it go? And when will it eventually run out of steam? Because Distell is at a record high. And we can see now, and I want to put use a horizontal graph in again, so that it is a clear line in the sand. For weeks now, since that week of the 31st of May this year, the share could not change 174.99 into a support and keep it one. That is seen as negative. So I would be careful here, Marguerite, unless you started small and are building a long-term position and your exposure is not too much, then yes, you can. Where will Distell warn again? Obviously below this strong support there in that week of the 28th of June, 2021. And that is waiting at 162.49. Below that level, I would say be careful, because then should Distell find resistance again here, and start to retrace, we might, and I say might because it's far away from it at the moment, might sit here with a possible double top. And we know those are warning formations telling us, hey, the top of this year might be in place, rather consider a short or taking some profit. So let's hope that's not a double top on Distell. And again, as I've said, if that high starts to change into a support, the momentum to the top can continue. Kern wanted us to look at Anglo Gold. He asked for a long position. Ken, I agree with you. It is nicely oversold. There's higher lows on your Williams percentage R. Let's make that middle line a lot thicker so you can see that minus 50 level. Once that minus 50 level starts to change into a support, we can assume that the momentum to the top can escalate. I've said it many a times. All our gold counters on our exchange has got head and shoulder formations on them. Many of them, even in their right shoulders, they've got smaller head and shoulder formations. The gold price has to change its 40-week moving average, waiting at $1,818 into a support before I can be, and keep it a support before I can be a bit more optimistic about our gold counters. Yes, it can easily bounce. So I've got beautiful support there around 262.45. I think you can consider a long year at current levels, but stop loss is that 262.45. I would keep that line in the sand there. You can either use the tails or the real bodies. I would prefer the real bodies. There's more touching points. Let's just see. That's maybe, no. Let's keep it at 262.45. Now I'm not going to get that. There you go. I would use that line in the sand. And what I did is I tested our average true range on Anglo Gold is R27.22, Ken. So you are giving Anglo Gold enough breathing space to say, hey, maybe if that gold price can change the 40-week into a support, maybe that strong support here at 262.45 can remain into place. Take a look, and exactly the same story I said about Tencent, Naspers and Prusas. My 40-week moving average, it has to change into support and keep it one. The fact that Anglo Gold and many of our other gold shares tested our 40-week, could not change it into support and a retrace, is seen as negative. So yes, bounce definitely 262.45 as a possible stop loss for Anglo Gold. Uncle Matsy wanted us to look at Billiton. Also listed on our exchange, ticker BHP. Uncle Matsy, we can see overbought. That Williams percentage R indicator is overbought. But let's have a look here, because one, it's changed that 40-week moving average into a support, so that is seen as positive. But now the important thing is, will that resistance, where that tweezer top was formed here back in 22nd of February, that 1st of May, those 2 weeks, will that resistance, waiting at R495.12, change into a support? If it does that, and it keeps it a support, we can go back to brand new record highs on Billiton. But if it doesn't, and it starts to retrace again from it, that will be seen as a warning. And with this instrument, with Billiton being this overbought, I would maybe consider, I'm always so scared to short Billiton, but maybe consider a small short there. Keep in mind, the weakness of the rand will always play a part. And if we look at the strength of the dollar index and how it wants to play out, we can maybe expect a weaker rand. So just play that in your mind. Keep that in your mind, if you want to consider a short. But we are above the 40 week. And that means the long-term sentiment towards Billiton has changed to positive. Rue, and there was somebody else as well that wanted us to look at City Lodge. Let's quickly have a look at City Lodge. Also, a share that has been consolidating sideways for a while. That 40-week moving average, the red line, has changed into a support. So yes, that is fantastic. Now the big test is, look at my Williams percentage R. It looks like it has changed the minus 50 level into a support, but it's losing steam. And now the question is, will it keep it a support? If it does, that will mean, and we can assume then, that the momentum to the top can continue again. And look what we've got here, ladies and gentlemen, on City Lodge. A beautiful cup, small handle, where it tested that neckline again, with another possible handle here. So that strong resistance on City Lodge that has to change into a support is waiting at 450 Rand. Above 450 Rand, that formation will come into play. What's the target? The conservative target, length of the handle, projected upwards from the neckline, can take us back to 562. And more importantly, we've got a cup here, length of the cup, projected upwards from the handle, can take us back to 6.67, which is very close to that resistance we found on the 11th of August. And then, beauty as beautiful, the windows on City Lodge, because we know windows are nice targets. It almost pulls. Once the buyers are there and there are enough of them, it becomes like a magnet for a share. And that window on City Lodge is waiting between 7.16 and 6.86. So that 7.16 is a possible target that City Lodge can go to. Obviously, the graph will warn again below the 40-week moving average, and my lowest part of my handle is waiting at 3.37. Below 3.37, the optimism around City Lodge will be completely off the table. I'm so sorry we ran out of time, that we had so many requests. I hope the skills you learn, you can apply to your graph. If you've got questions next week, please feel free to send us a Twitter request or via an email. Have a fantastic week. Take care.